Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2313, checking for palindromes. Hey, wait, before you say, oh, that sounds so boring, I don't want to see this. There's a lot of cool Excel in this video, including the first time I've ever used that stupid, useless function CONCAT, and yet another two amazing uses for the Clark Kent of Excel dynamic arrays, sequence. All right, problem today, broadcast news oversimplifies things to fit into a 30-second story. This past weekend, big news item 0202-2020 is a palindrome hasn't happened again for 900 years, won't happen again for 1,000 years. And this is my brother-in-law, well, at least it's the wardrobe of my brother-in-law. He says, hang on a second, 1002-2001 was a palindrome that was less than 900 years ago. Well, the problem is, this wasn't the real story. The real story is this, is that 0202-2020 is a palindrome in all four date formats, right? That won't happen again in our lifetime. But just based on that first story, it's like, well, wait a second, that doesn't seem right. There has to be other palindromes. And I was thinking, is there a way in Excel to test for a palindrome? And I thought that this would be a great use for the new dynamic arrays. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do equal concat. And what I want is the mid of this word over here, apple. All right, and here, which number do I want to start with? Well, I want to start with a whole bunch of numbers. So I'm going to use the sequence function. I want one row of numbers. And how many columns? I want the length of A2. And where do I want to start? I want to start at the length of A2. And what direction do I want to go? I want to go -1. All right, so the mid of A2, starting at all of these numbers, how long do I want it? I want it to be one number. And I want to send that whole thing into the concat function. See, and it takes that word apple and it reverses it. All right, why does this work? Let's just look down here at elderberry, for example. That's a nice long one. What's the length of A7? The length of A7 is 10. If I ask for the sequence of one row, 10 columns, starting at 10, -1, I get the numbers 10 to 1, like that. But then, if I use the mid of A7, asking for the sequence, it generates those 10 letters, elderberry, basically backwards, and then concat of above. Now, I have to tell you, when I was preparing for this video, I started out using TEXTJOIN, but TEXTJOIN makes me say what goes in between each letter and what to do if there's empty cells, and in fact, I really don't need that. So I always say that TEXTJOIN is an amazing function and it just runs circles around concat, but in this particular case, concat is shorter and simpler. And that's great. And hey, by the way, a couple days ago on Monday, I showed you that great new fast Excel from Charles Williams. It has a function that would just make this whole podcast be 10 seconds, reverse.txt. So if you happen to have bought that, well, that's an easier way to go. All right, so let's go back to our problem. Are there other dates that are palindromes? And in Excel, the very first date starts January 1st, 1900. So we can't test anything before that. So I'm just going to generate a whole bunch of dates here. And I'm going to do how many rows? Let's see. If I put in today, it'll give me every day from January 1st, 1900 up until today. But I want to look into the future too. So I'm going to say today times 2. One column, starting at 1, that's January 1st, 1900, stepping by 1. Oh, wait, 111, I don't need that. That's the default. So very simply here, sequence of today will generate all of the dates. We'll generate all of the dates. If I would change this into a short date, you see that it goes all the way out to 2140. All right, that's longer than any of us are going to live. But in fact, I don't want this to be dates at all because I want to format it into MMDDYYY format. So that one formula there, I'm going to wrap it in the text function. And what text do we want to use? We want to use this format right here. Press enter. And there we have all of the dates from 01/01/1900, January 1st, 1900, out to March 9th of 2140. That's our test. All right, now I already wrote this great formula here to put it backwards. We'll copy that. And then ask, is this equal to that? All right, now we want to double click to copy this down. That bug in Excel has finally been fixed. It used to be that that was an array formula over there. It was not working. I reported that to Joe McDaid. He says, oh, we'll get to it, we'll get to it. Well, great news. They finally got to it. So that's an exciting thing right there. And then turn on date filter and look for things that are true, and we'll find all of the dates in MMDDYY format that are palindromes. So here's the one that just happened, 02/02/2020. But it also happened on November 2nd, 2011. It's going to happen again on December 2nd, 2021, March 2nd of 2030. So, hey, if you missed this past Sunday, well, look, it's going to happen again. Now, here, I'm going to make all of these be red. And then up here, we'll change to the European date format, DDMMYYYY. All right, and then I want to look again for the things that are true. Do I have to open that drop down? No, I can go to the Data tab and choose Reapply. That'll get me all the trues, and sure enough, there was only one that is a palindrome in both, although 12/12/2021, sorry, I'm not going to make it there. Maybe my great-grandkids will make it there. And then we can also look for palindromes in YYYY, MMDD, and Reapply. Alright, a whole bunch there, and then in YYYY, DDMM. And Reapply. And a whole bunch there, right? So, hey, cool way to check for palindromes using the concat of the mid of the sequence using length. Cool little formula there. Also, a great way to generate, well, heck, every date in our lifetime using one formula up in A2. And kudos to my brother-in-law, you're right, there's lots of other days that are palindromes if this was the news story that you heard. Now, dynamic arrays, brand new to Excel. Check out this ebook, $3, Excel Dynamic Arrays, straight to the point. Click that I in the top right-hand corner. If you enjoy useless facts like this while learning some cool things about Excel, please subscribe and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.